Our third game is underway right here. It is the Kentucky Premier Squad going up against West Virginia Thunder Gold. And, of course, Kentucky Premier is led by Aaron Bolin. We'll see them as Johnson brings it into the forecourt now. So it'll be Johnson, Ansley Eubank. Glad to see Eubank back on the floor. Got that knee wrapped up. Think that she's going to be okay. Down low. There it is. Gibson, an easy layup. So it'll be Gibson getting it going early with her first two. Ansley Eubank, notice, has that right wrap on her right knee, and I'm glad that she's okay. There's a long three out of the corner. No good by Conglington. Conglington, and now jump ball, and it will go over to Kentucky Premier. So the next possession will go over to West Virginia. The Thunder. The Thunder all in the Navy, and Kentucky Premier all in the light gray with the green trim. Aaron Boley puts it on the floor. Aaron Boley with a nice move. Shot up. No good. They tip. Fight for the rebound. It's going to come down to Dunham. Dunham has it now and pushes it up ahead quickly. Down low. Shot up. No, she got foul going up. Eisenman playing with this gold team. She split her free throw, did Eisenman. So it's 2-1. And it might be a pretty good matchup with her having Bowley in there. Courtney Eisenman out of Upper Arlington. Floating up by Galloway is no good. Aaron Bowley going to come away with it. Bowley holding it, holding it. To call a timeout. They gave her a trap right there. West Virginia Thunder there with Dawson. Jordan Dawson and Aaliyah Dunham right there. Aaliyah Dunham out of South Charleston. They provided that trap right there. 2-1. So Aaron Bowley had to call the timeout. It is a 30-second timeout. Each team will get two fulls and two 30s. Joe Hillsman, Jonathan Hemingway here with you, and we know much, Mr. Hemingway, about this Kentucky Premier team. I think an interesting change here on this West Virginia Thunder gold team is they brought Eisenman over, match up with Gibson and Bowley to give us some work.
Let me tell you, we have two of the premier programs in the country facing off against one another here today. Coach David Tapley, Jared Parmalee, you know, obviously with Kentucky Premier, you know, loaded, you know, with talent from top to bottom. Aaron Bowley, most certainly an All-American, McDonald's All-American. Naismith, you know, Player of the Year watch list. And then on the other hand, you got Scott Johnson, who has done just a fantastic job of building his program from the, you know, from the bottom up. He's got a great group of 2016 kids, headlined by Taryn McCutcheon, Lexi Barrier. McCutcheon on the way, you know, going to Michigan State. Lexi Barrier, you know, one of the more highly recruited, you know, prospects. But this gold team is his second team, and it is equally as talented. You have prospects that are being looked at and watched very closely from coaches, you know, all over the country, including Courtney Eisenman, who makes that putback.
Who normally plays on the lead team. So they dropped her down. Just, I mean, why not? You're going up against Aaron Bowley and Shelby Gibson. Now, on the baseline, of course. Now, let's set that lineup for you now. And a good thing we got to see Ansley Eubank back in after she had a slight injury on that right knee, but she got it wrapped up. She's out there, number 15. Eubank, Duval, Bowley, Gibson, and Robinson, the five on the floor for Kentucky Premier. Dawson and Dunham on the floor, along with Conglington, Eisenman,
and Mayo.
And Mayo. long three. Duval, it was short. Eisenman gets the short rebound. It's 4-3 right now. Kentucky Premier with the lead. And now Dawson gets it over to Collington. Collington, pump fake on Boley. Going to go with a right-hand layup. No. And let's see. Well, we're going to get a whistle on a foul. And Coach Johnson wanted that foul. He got it, walked up almost in front of us to get that call.
Yeah, that shot came out a little errant, and you had to think that somebody clapped her on the arm right here. But Congleton was one of the stock risers coming out of the spring, the tip-off classic. Just a high-energy, two-way player. Can make it happen on the offensive end. You saw the slash of the bucket, but it's her defensive intensity, ability to rebound her position that really separates her as a 2016 prospect.
And she hit both free throws, and they have the lead 5-4. So here's Robinson. Robinson now to Eubank. Eubank holds, throws it out to the ring, gives it out to Gibson. Gibson gives it over to Robinson. Robinson going to come to the right, being worked on really hard by Dunham. Had to pick a dribble up. There's Gibson. Gibson, a foul line jumper. In and out. No, they tip, fight for the rebound, out of bounds. It will go to West Virginia. So off of Aaron Boley and West Virginia, all in the Navy. Navy tops and Navy bottoms, and Kentucky Premier all in the gray. They're trimmed in that lime green. Mayo has it. Christian Mayo. Kick it back over. Here's Dunham. Dunham holds it. And they'll pull it back out. She has Dawson out there with her. Here's Mayo going in the corner to Coglington. Coglington puts it on the floor with the right-hand dribble. Running the offense, everything above the perimeter at the moment. Mayo to Dawson. Dawson hard dribble. Foul line jumper. She was contested in your face. Take that.
Scott Johnson has just been singing the praises of Jordan Dawson. 5'9", 2016 prospect out of Huntington, West Virginia. Yeah, you can see why. Great frame, the ability to hit the jumper.
Gibson, nice post move. She was upset, came back and got her second field goal, the verbal to Ole Miss. Here's Christian Mayo. Mayo quickly into the forecourt, swings it in the corner to Coglington. Coglington now holding and directing traffic, being worked on by Boley. She peels it back out.
She got blood.
11 and a half. And Eisenman got hit, and we've got blood on her face, and we'll have infection control and a substitution.
I think she might have gotten that bloody nose with that elbow from Gibson on that pivot. Never want to use the word violent, but when Gibson pivots on the low block, it's definitely a violent move, and they're going to have to wipe up some of this blood here.
Yeah, we're going to have to wipe it up on the floor as well. Eisenman got popped. She's got it down there. I think she's going to be okay.
Yeah, I think she's a tough kid. Tough competitors out here.
Infection control. And we're going to have to get up the blood here on the floor. 11:27 to go. Seven to six. West Virginia Thunder with the lead, and let's take a look here at our ProspectNation.com instant replay. And it's Dawson hitting that jumper right in the mouth of Gibson right there at the foul line, and she confidently let that stroke go to give them that lead. It's now 7-6. So as we wait for infection control to take over, we're going to go ahead and take another look here. He's looking into that huddle of Scott Johnson. So we're going to step away right now. 11:27 to go, SUV TV. So Hillsman, Jonathan Hemingway back here with you. Marietta, Georgia, Swanee Sports Academy, 7-6, West Virginia leading. The West Virginia Thunder goal leading Kentucky Premier. We just had a stoppage of play for infection control, but we're back and we're ready to go. And behind the back goes Coglington, and she missed it. Dunham got the rebound, but we have a foul underneath. All right, so Gabby Leprados is into the game, also wearing 32 for West Virginia. And the interesting thing about her is she used nothing to tie her hair up. That is the whole thing that we've talked about with her the last 2 days. She uses nothing on her hair.
That's her signature.
Exactly.
You know, some people like to put the Sky Digs, you know, hairband in. Not her. She's free-flowing, and that kind of really represents her game, too. You know, she plays with so much energy. You know, nothing really constrains her.
That's pretty much right. McCune layup, a pass was no good off the layup to Duval. Lindsay Duval blew the layup. Eisenman got the blood stopped, and now she got it patched up, and she ready to go.
Tough kid, man. Tough kid. Just comes running right back out onto the court. Got the little gauze up there in the nose. She's ready to go. Watch this West Virginia Thunder offense as you see Mayo go right down the lane, can't get the foul call. They run the chin series, a series of flares and back screens.
Dawson up, no good. Rebound coming down. McCune is into the contest now. Chris McCune. And now here's Robinson. Robinson in the corner. Bowley, a short corner three. In and out, no. Rebound comes down. Grace Berger is into the game. Berger now to Bowley. Bowley going to peel it back and now drive. Got it knocked away as she went to the hoop. I think I find something new about Aaron Bowley every single time. Class of 2016, 6'3", Hodgsonville, Kentucky, and very versatile. Robinson will inbound it, looking. Looking, Robinson gets it in to Berger. Berger trapped over there in that corner, so they give it back over to Robinson, get it down to McCune. McCune, layup, no. Tip, rebound, tip again. Bowley's going to come away with it. And now pull a three from the left wing. It's short. Rebound comes down to Jordan Dawson. Dawson in transition for West Virginia. Bowley was staying with her and stole the pass. Gives it up to Grace Berger. Now Berger into the forecourt slowly. Kicks it over to Reese, and Reese is going to get fouled as she goes in. Allison Neese, nope, called jump ball. Jump ball, and it'll go over to West Virginia.
One thing I want the viewers at home to watch about number 21 from Kentucky Premier, Aaron Bowley, versatility. You see her rebounding the basketball, shooting jumpers, running in transition, getting steals. You know, oftentimes, you know, the name of the game now in the game of basketball is positionless players, and Aaron Bowley really exemplifies that.
I concur with you 100%, and she goes hard. I've not seen her take a play off all year.
Right.
Was that a driving and one by Dawson? It was. Jordan Dawson, a driving and one, her second field goal. 5'9" out of Huntington, West Virginia, and Huntington High School. And here it is, our ProspectNation.com instant replay right on McCune, and she completes the three-point play. So look at this, 10-6. West Virginia, this is their second-tier team going up against the top team for Kentucky Premier. Just going to note what you mentioned about the program of Scott Johnson. Aaron Bowley with her first two of the game.
Right on cue, Aaron Bowley posting up, and I think that's what truly makes her versatile. You know, so many times people get caught up in versatility, and they think versatility is a big kid playing on the perimeter. Well, if you just float around the arc but never have that interior presence, that's not truly versatile. Bowley really exemplifies. Her production comes inside and out.
Outside, that three is no good. Rebound is high by Neese out to Berger. Grace Berger now swings it back to Neese. McCune had a seal. McCune layup.
Good.
A good seal there. 6'4", class of 2016 out of Louisville, Kentucky, in Manuel.
McCune, nice left-handed lay-in. She used her body well to gain that position, an elite 100 prospect.
Haley Hall on the pump fake. The jumper is no good. Grace Berger gets the rebound. Berger running in. No, that's Neese. Over to Robinson. Robinson lost it. Stolen away by Mayo. Mayo's pass now intercepted by Berger. Berger now going to try to push the tempo a little bit in that left corner. Gives it down to Neese. Neese goes on the baseline and a double dribble called on Allison Neese. Neese, class of 2018, 5'8", out of Simon Kenton.
Let's just say here for a moment, Kentucky Premier is not going anywhere
Oh no.
Very quickly. Nice 2018, Berger 2018, Robinson 2018, Duval 2017. All these kids are coming back, and they're going to be good for a while.
20 all, and there's a long three, Christian Mayo. Mayo just dropped a long three.
Big time shot from Mayo. She's one of my favorite players from this group. Plays with a lot of energy, real skilled, and as you can see, she can shoot it.
Robinson missed it. Now a long three by Gabby Lapardos. It's no good. Rebound comes down to Robinson. Robinson up ahead. Here's Allison East on the break. Allison going to go off the window. No McCune on the offensive rebound. Rips, fight, foul. Let's see. They say no shot. Foul is going to be called on Haley Hall, number 10. So now checking in will be Malaika Frank. She will be taking the place of Marquesa Robinson.
Number 11 in gray, that's Malaika Frank. You mentioned her. She's already given her verbal commitment to Western Kentucky University. Good things going on in Bowling Green, Kentucky.
Yes, it is. Up ahead now, here's Mayo. 7.5 to go, 13-10. West Virginia with the lead. West Virginia penetrating with Mayo. Her shot is no good. Comes away with it. Now is Nice up ahead to Boley. Boley's running the break. Boley with the Euro step all the way through. Travel. Traveling violation called on Aaron Boley. 13-10, 7:21 to go. Now Boley will go out, and now comes in Ayala Green.
You kind of understand now why Coach Johnson slid Eisenman over to this this second team. Boley, Gibson, McCune, Green. There's a lot of size over here, and Eisenman. is very much needed along that front line.
Eisenman is back into the contest. Put it on the floor, Mayo. Slid Mayo over as well. Thunder tried to feed the post. Going to be taken away by Frank. Frank leading the break. She's got Green with her, but she's not. Doesn't see it. Berger. Berger, one dribble. Stop, pop. No good. Off the side of the rim. Rebound is going to be ripped down. Who was that? That was Mayo down there fighting with the trees. They got the rebound. Mayo up ahead. Now she's looking at the offense. They'll set it up. There's Eisenman. Eisenman back in, blood and all. You got me habitually now, Hemi, looking at the shoes, and this one is a Kyrie versus Kobe deal. Gabby Lapardos looking. Parham upset at the referee over something. Lapardos drive. There's a kick. Haley Hall, a three, back iron. No, it hit the rope. And that will be a jump ball and go over to Kentucky Premier. Substitutions now. Conglington will come in and Dunning will come in. Going out will be O'Mara and Mayo. Parham discussing something with one of the referees right there. He doesn't agree with it. He didn't like that call at all. Now here's Frank. Frank between the rings, swings it over to Berger. Coming up on 6 minutes to go, 13-10. She feeds the post to McCune. McCune with a post move. Now spins. Shot up. No, she got fouled by Eisenman and will go to the free throw line with 5:56 to go.
I like what I'm seeing out of Chris McCune here today. You know, her calling card has always been defense and rebounding, that physical presence, block shots, you know, control the glass. The question mark has always been, you know, how much offensive skill is there? You know, can she be a primary post option, or is she just going to be a rebound putback kid? And here today, you've seen it a couple of different times, the seal and the left-handed finish, and now drawing the foul on the spin move and the pivot. McCune showing a little bit more expanded offensive skill set here today.
McCune splits the free throw. She has three in the contest now, 3 points. It's 13-11. Robinson will check in, and now Allison Nice will check out for Kentucky Premier. So it's Berger, Robinson, Frank, Green and McCune, the five on the floor for Kentucky Premier. Lapratis, Collington, Eisenman, Collington driving, she got fouled. Dunham and Hall, the five on the floor for West Virginia.
Let me tell you something, Joel. This is the place to be if you are a prospect. I mean, you got Louisville staff right over there sitting three deep. You got Michigan State's assistant coach, Nikhil Copeland, also sitting in front row. You look along the back line, and you got Gino Ariema and his assistant coach sitting here. You got Coach Mitchell from Ohio State, Iowa State assistant is here. I mean, this is Logo Row, not to mention Dean Lockwood from the University of Tennessee. These young ladies right here are gaining unparalleled exposure here at the PSB Summer Invitational.
Free throw split. Gibson with the rebound up ahead to Robinson. Robinson now in and out dribble, going down the lane, floating it up. No, a tip fight for the rebound. They battle for it underneath their own basket. It'll be taken out to West Virginia. 14 to 11, 5:36 to go. Hall will inbound it and gives it to Dunham. Dunham getting her instructions from Coach Johnson with 5.5 to go. She walks it into the forecourt.
Coach Johnson calling for his chin series once again. You'll notice Eisman playing in the high post. She's going to set a lot of back screens and a lot of ball screens. They got a back screen for her right here. She kicks it out.
Haley Hall, a right wing three. It is short. No, good defense there, but they didn't get the rebound to finish the defense. So Hall going to run with a little floater off the glass. Good. Haley Hall with her floater, her first points. Did not finish the defense, did Kentucky Premier. You must get the rebound to finish it. Joel, Robinson into the forecourt.
Yeah, we talk about it all the time. You got to finish plays. Defensive rebounds win games.
Traveling on Gibson. Gibson has kind of been neutralized so far. You know, we saw her on Thursday. Really does work on the boards. That's what she's known for. Kind of been taken away from that game today on the glass.
Well, after that big pivot that she had into Eisenman, she took a seat. Regained her breath, but her and Boley now checking back into the game to finish the last 5 minutes of this first half.
And Eisenman playing with a little bit of that edge. You're not going to bloody my nose and think I'm not going to play, especially with who, as you mentioned, Logo Rowe, showing that toughness.
Oh, no question. Eisenman, let me tell you something. Post players nationally, you know, there aren't a lot of kids, you know, out there with her size, stature, and skill set. And she's even shown the ability to step out to the arc, you know, hit the outside jumper. If that's something that she can do consistently, imagine some of these logos to make an offer.
Aaron Boley's long three, struggling to find the range, but Robinson gets the offensive rebound. Robinson on the attack with Haley. Nice cross, jump, good. Beautiful.
Mikasa Robinson, 2018 point guard. Boy, she electric, Joel.
Ashlyn High now driving this way. Coglington with the layup.
Good pass there by, that was Dunham, I believe, in the full court, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, Dunham playing very well as she's checked back into the contest. Here's Frank. Frank out to Eubank. Eubank with the left-hand dribble, now the right over to Frank. They're trying to feed it to Boley. They won't let her get it down in there. Now Frank goes and drives and gets fouled.
Frank is a good addition to this Kentucky Premier team, and let me tell you why. She's a different type of player than what they already have, you know, on the perimeter. A left-handed kid who primarily loves to slash, you know, to the bucket. She really specializes in defending, rebounding, getting to the lane, you know, all of those things. You know, when you look at, you know, Duvall and Berger, those are kids that like to spot up and, you know, shoot jumpers. But Frank can really mix it up on the interior.
Free throws no good by Frank. Boley gets the rebound. Boley goes back up, shot no, and another whistle, and let's see, going to go against Kentucky Premier. Loose ball, foul called on Michaela Frank.
And right on cue, Frank almost got that offensive rebound, but she climbed up the back, of the West Virginia Thunder defender.
Dunham and Dawson will walk it into the forecourt. Also joining them on the floor now, I have not given her love, is Taylor Cashwell, number 12 for West Virginia Navy. 18-13, West Virginia with the lead. They are in the navy blue. And Aaron Boley shot the passing lane. Boley going to come all the way on the break. Layup. Good, Aaron Boley. Her second field goal of the contest. That cuts it down to three. And now a little full court pressure. And Boley tipped it away. Still going to be picked up by Eubank. Eubank fouled in the backcourt by Cashwell.
This is what big-time players do at big-time moments. You know, just a moment ago, it was an eight-point game. Boley comes up with back-to-back steals, and she doesn't always have to do it on the offensive end. That's what makes Aaron Boley one of the top five players nationally, is because not only is she a versatile player, but she's a two-way player.
Here's Robinson. Robinson, tricky dribbles again, gets to the right of the lane, shot is short. Dawson gets the rebound for West Virginia. Gibson took it away. Shelby Gibson stole it and put it in the hoop. 6 points for her. Murfreesboro, Tennessee, Oakland, class of 2016. A long three. There's Coglington, no good. Gibson now getting active, grabbed that rebound of Robinson. They're down one, trying to take the lead. Robinson below the free throw line, up, foul, two shots. She's going to the line.
And a big sequence right there for Shelby Gibson. You saw the strong hands along the front line and the finish. That's what Matt Insel and his staff saw, you know, nearly 6 months ago. And the reason why they, you know, extended an offer to her is the fact that she can rebound the ball and she can score around the paint. And she can do it on both ends, too.
Yeah, and when she shoots her second free throw, she missed it. There you go, behind the back. And then that little pull-up jumper there, beautiful. ProspectNation.com, instant replay. Robinson missed both free throws, 2:23 to go. Now they kick it to Mayo. Mayo stops, a left wing three. Kaboom. Kristen Mayo with a three, her second three here in the contest to push the lead back out 21-18.
And again, it was Coach Johnson's chin series right there. Mayo receiving the flare screen, knocking down the big jumper.
There is Grace Berger. Berger, a pull-up long. Boley skying for the board. Boley goes back up. It was deflected. Frank Hustle out of bounds, and it will go to West Virginia. Eisenman holding her own. West Virginia technically holding their own against this vaunted front line of the Kentucky Premier Squad.
Run it again.
Coach Johnson says run it again. Dunham is running the point. Gives it down, tried to go to Eisenman. Boley is going to take it away after Gibson bothered it. Gives it over to Robinson. Robinson skips into the forecourt, goes below the lane, driving, blew the easy layup. Rebound, Eisenman. Eisenman to Dunham, and that's 135 to go. Dunham slipped, lost her foot, goes between the legs, and will peel it back out and send it to Eisenman. Eisenman says, okay, I'll pull it. Bang! Courtney Eisenman showing the range with the three ball.
I told you, she can shoot that jumper. The question is consistency, and she's showing right now that she's got a lot of confidence in it.
Berger being really frustrated by Mayo right here on his right wing. A timeout called by Parham. Parham is upset, goes and grabs the clip and wants to write something up. It's 24-18. And here you go on our ProspectNation.com instant replay. Catch, shoot. I can do that.
Can you, Joel?
Yeah, I can, but I was talking about her. But I can do that, yeah. Hang around.
You got a jumper just like Marcus?
Oh, 10 times better than him.
Oh, wow, okay.
My range started when I walked in the gym.
I see.
Yeah, I can shoot the jumper now.
Well, me and you are going to
have to. He might be quicker than me.
Well.
But I still can shoot.
Marcus is strong now. He can put the ball on the floor. He's got those biceps. He'll put it right in your jaw.
Any shooting contest, sign me up for it. Let's go.
Okay.
Anyone else? We got, that's the fun we have. See, you see what this just turned into? Here's Grace Berger. She can shoot, too.
She sure can. She can handle it.
She inbounds to Robinson. Robinson to Gibson. Gibson to Frank. Frank goes on the baseline. Floated up, left hand, got the roll.
Great poise right there by Premier. West Virginia comes out with a little 2-2-1 half-court trap, and they handled it beautifully and turns it into 2 points.
Exactly. That's exactly what I'm going to say. And then they came out of the timeout. So Parham did a great job calling the timeout. They were able to execute and get that bucket. 24-20. Shot off. No good. Rebound by Frank. Taken away from behind by Collington. She just took it. Took her cookies and laid that thing in. Dasha Collington out of Huntington, West Virginia. Robinson swings it now. Here's Berger. Berger feeding the post now to Gibson. Gibson to Boley. Boley with the dribble. Stop, turn, fire. Good. Just tough.
Let me tell you something. We have seen some great players here at this tournament over the years. Kelsey Mitchell, Catherine Westbeld, Michaela Waterman, Erin Boley's putting her name right alongside all of those kids.
Dunham driving. Boley gets the foul. Dawson on the drive, 7-8, 10 seconds. 26-22, and I got a hunch this one ain't over.
Nah, not even close. Not even close.
Not far from over. Jordan Dawson will be going to the free throw line. 5'9 out of Huntington. She has 5 points, and she just stroked. Missed that first free throw, trying to look like she can stroke in the second one. 7-8, 10 seconds. Free throw, in and out, no. Struggling, Gibson on the glass. So they've got 6 seconds up ahead. Here comes Robinson. Robinson quickly into the forecourt, into the corner. There goes Niece. No, that's Eubank. Eubank didn't see the clock. She didn't see the clock. 26-22 at the half. Kentucky Premier trailing West Virginia Thunder right here. SUV TV, ProspectNation.com. It's the replay. Erin Boley. Man, that's just a Sunday stroll in the park for Miss Bowl.
Let me tell you something, and like I mentioned before, some of the great players that have come through this tournament over the years, I mentioned Mitchell, Taya Cooper, you know, Paris Key, some of those marquee matchups over the year. Erin Boley is you know, positioning herself, you know, as, you know, a premier player nationally as a result of this stage. But right now, you got to tip your cap to Coach Johnson and the West Virginia Thunder. What they've done so far to have a 4-point lead going into the half is very special.
All right, we'll step out for this quick timeout right here. SUV TV. Joe Hillsman and now Chris Watkins back here with you. Hashtag PSB Summer Invite. It is Kentucky Premier taking on the West Virginia Thunder gold. Kentucky Premier in the gray, running their offense. There's Duval. There you go, see? There you go. Uh-huh. They had to have a stoppage of a moment and the clock operator sleep.
Hey, but that should be in half court, man.
And Coach Johnson wants it at half court, not going to get it. Aaron Boley, stop, jumper, good. Aaron Boley knocking him down. Now she has eight. Remember, she's 6'3", class of 2016, out of Hogginville, Kentucky. So now here is Coglinton over to Kristen Mayo. So it's Mayo, Dawson, Eisenman, Dunnan, and Coglinton on the floor. And there's Mayo, floater, good. She floated it right up over Aaron Boley.
Coach Johnson does such a great job getting his team in the right sets, especially to run that set there versus zone here early in the second half.
Now Robinson holds between the legs. She goes around. Robinson going to pull a three. Oh, banking hours on a Saturday afternoon in Georgia for Miss Robinson. Class of 2018. Here's Dunham. Dunham holds it now. The Conglington. Conglington now. Gonna work down the lane. It was deflected and blocked by Boley. She recovered it though. Collington in the paint. Now the ball is loose. They're gonna pick it up, and that's gonna be Duval who picked it up. Dunning deflected the pass, and it will go over to Kentucky Premier. 28-27. Robinson will walk it into the forecourt. Robinson now with the left-hand dribble being picked up by Dunnan. Dunnan going to pull it back out. Coach Johnson giving them instructions. She swings it to Gibson. Gibson back over to Eubank. Eubank, hard press dribble between the rings. Now kicks it over to Duval. Duval lost it. Now recovers it. Good pressure from Mayo. Now she shook her down. Going to go down below the free throw line. Shot is up, no good. Eisenman gets the rebound for West Virginia Thunder. So Eisenman going to give it up ahead to Dunnan. Dunham into the forecourt, and now she'll get the call. Swings it over, a long three, Collington, no good. Rebound on the floor, picked up by Duval, harassed by Mayo, and a foul.
Hey, stay away from
Bowley, Bowley moving to the right. Shot was short and bothered. Here comes Coglington. Coglington back this way, up ahead. Mayo running the break, layup. No, it rolled off. And Bowley got the rebound. Here's Duval. She traveled, no call. Now Mayo comes in from behind. 13:41 to go, 28-27. And West Virginia Thunder with the lead. Kentucky Premier trying to get back up in front. Looking, now going to kick it out. There's a long three by Duval, front iron, no. Gibson on the offensive glass to Bowley. Bowley, one hard dribble, pop, shot, no, long. And rebound, Eubank, another offensive opportunity. So she pulls a long three, kaboom. Ansley Eubank out of Oakland, class of 2016. 5'8", hits the three, and now the Premier have the lead, 30-28. They've been climbing that mountain most of the game.
Big time shot there by Eubank. That just shows her confidence in a shooter, because most times if you miss that shot, the coach is about to yank you. Getting the offensive rebound, stepping back for the three.
Dawson going to drive. Up, counted, and the foul. Jordan Dawson driving and scoring again. Dawson now with seven with the and one, took the contact.
Showing she's not afraid of another Dame commit there. Aaron Bowley driving right at her, making sure she herself initiated that contact before she got the and one there at the rim.
Yes, she did. An outstanding job there. Free throw good by Jordan Dawson. She completes the three-point play. Dawson with eight. Coach Johnson now stressing exactly what you just mentioned there, Chris, about offensive rebounds. He only wants them to get one shot, and now we've got a whistle, and what happened? The clock, 13:02. So Bowley inbounds now to Robinson. Robinson now back in his corner, Duval. Duval a three, good. Lindsey Duval a three. The three ball's now beginning to fall. The jumpers and all for this Kentucky Premier team. There goes Coglington driving, scooping up lay, no. 12:46 to go, 33-31. Kentucky Premier leading, but now going to the free throw line for Kentucky Premier is Deja Coglington. Coglington first free throw is no good, a two-point ball game. Coglington will get another one. It is up. It is back iron. No good. Rebound now comes down to Duval. Duval gives it over to Robinson. So leaving points at the free throw line right now, West Virginia off. Berger came off the screen. Worked on by Coglington on that right wing. She's very high, low. Now kick it over to Bowley. Bowley going to go around the McCune screen. Now feed it to McCune. McCune on the right block. Worked on by Eisenman. Fell down, and it'll be a traveling violation on McCune. So here comes Dunning to walk it in a two-point game. This one's going to come down to the wire here, Chris. Hope you're ready to hold on.
That's what it's like here on Championship Saturday.
Mayo with the floater, no. Fighting for it down on the ground. It's going to be a jump ball. McCune and Wiseman. And possession arrow will go to West Virginia. Just over 4 minutes gone by. 2:16-minute half, so let's see. Allison Neese will check in. And Lindsey Duval will take a seat. Dunham will be inbounding it right in front of Tennessee. And Dunham inbound, come back in, shot the three, no. Bowley gets the rebound, puts it on the floor. Now Bowley gives it up ahead to Robinson. Robinson now to McCune. McCune was open, and White Eisenman is going to get hit with the foul. McCune will go to the line and shoot two. So we've been stuck on 33-31 for just a minute. Joe Hillsman, Chris Watkins, glad that you're with us here. ProspectNations.com. The PSB Summer Invitation powered by SUV TV, and McCune is at the line. Chris McCune, free throw, no.
Really like what Robinson there pushing the tempo. I mean, when you're the point guard and you put pressure on the defense like that, like she did there just with that simple pitch ahead, it makes it hard, you know, for the other team to be able to get back.
McCune taking her time. Here's her second free throw attempt. In and out and in. So McCune has 4 points, a field goal, and two free throws. And Dunham is into the forecourt with the right-hand dribble. Go belt high, stop, going to pull up off the jumper. It's no good. Rebound is Robinson of Kentucky Premier with 11:35 to go. She gives it to McCune. McCune on the floor, one hard dribble, up, foul by Dawson. Dawson knew she was out of position, had to foul anyway. McCune will be going back to the strike.
That's back-to-back possessions there, Robinson, McCune, and now McCune stepping to the free throw line again, continually putting pressure on the Thunder to get back.
So McCune will shoot her free throw. Free throw, back iron, no good. Hall will come in, as well as Omar will come in. Eisenman will go out, Dawson will come in. I think Eisenman has to go get her nose looked at again. 34-31, 11:31 to go. McCune free throw good. So she split them. 35-31 now, 4-point lead. Under 11 and a half to go. So here is, there's a jumper by O'Mara. O'Mara's shot no good. Boley gets the rebound. Aaron Boley everywhere. Here's Robinson. Robinson into the forecourt. Robinson now swings it over Berger. Berger on the right wing holding. Now between the ring is the Robinson with 11 minutes to go. 4-point Kentucky Premier lead. They give it to Boley. Boley a hard dribble up. Count it! And the foul, Aaron Boley, and one. She has 10 in the contest. We'll be going to the free throw line. That foul called on number 10, Haley Hall, of the West Virginia Thunder gold.
Really starting to see here now in the second half how the size of Kentucky Premier is starting to really take advantage there of West Virginia Thunder. What Bowley's done so far just in this half, she's gotten every single defensive rebound here, probably 8 defensive rebounds so far here in the first 6 minutes.
Bowley completes the 3-point play. She has 11. She's beginning to warm to the task in this ball game. They push that lead out to 8, beginning to show some separation, which you expected when you saw these two matchups coming together. But Coach Johnson knows how to keep his ball club in it. Hall gets the rebound, a long one. Here's Gabby LaPratis. She gives it over to Haley Hall, 10:35 to go. Coach Johnson very much engaged. He sees what he sees and he wants them to be patient. Hall on a pump fake, got Boley off her feet. Gabby gonna drive, there's Dunham. Dunham gonna go, floater down the free throw line, below it, no. Rebound gonna come off of Grace Berger. Berger and McCune both hit it. I think it went off Berger last in a 7-point game with 10:20 to go. O'Mara is into the contest. Got a little burn in that first half. Now they give it down. There's Gabby LaPratis. LaPratis being hacked away on by Robinson. No call. Out to Dunham. Dunham holds it. Right-hand dribble. Belt high. Swings it over to Haley Hall. Haley Hall now gives it over to Mayo. Mayo back to Hall. Hall being guarded by Boley, who would not let her drive on. Gabby LaPratis is now backing it out, under 10 minutes to go. The defense now stiffening it up a little bit for Kentucky Premier. Eisenman will be back in here momentarily. There goes Haley Hall. Haley drive, kicks in the corner to Dunham. Dunham a three, no good. Rebound tip out of bounds. And it will stay down here with West Virginia. Dunham will be inbounding it for West Virginia. 9:44 to go. Joe Hillsman, Chris Watkins, glad that you're with us right here, ProspectNation.com, powered by SUV TV. Remember, the hashtag is PSB, Summer Invite. In one of the most highly anticipated championship games here on Championship Saturday, and the place is packed. Running the offense out high at the perimeter right now, 9:25 to go, and now a whistle. You hear Hemi talk about that chin offense. He's had to change it up a couple of times now here in this second half with the strategy.
Yeah, most times when they go to the chin series, they're looking to get some action out of the high post, maybe get a back door. Look right there, they're actually trying to get a back door cut there for Gabby on the cut. They weren't able to get her.
Dunham hit with a – oh, no, a foul is on Grace Berger. Berger will get the foul. Berger been quiet in her time in the game. The other day we had her on the network, she had 7 points. We had her back here in April where she just lit fire and played great in the PSB preseason. Coach Parm gets some instructions from the ref, and we are able to go play ball now. Kick it over into the corner. Gabby LaPratis back over. There's Haley Hall, a right wing three. Back iron, no good. Rebound to LaPratis, offensive rebound. Another opportunity here. Pass was deflected and now will be a steal. Knees came away with the steal. Here's Robinson. Robinson to McCune. A great pass and dime and a good finish for McCune. Her second field goal, her 7th point. Dunham to Kristen Mayo. Mayo's three, no good. Boley skies in, gets the rebound, and gives it over to Grace Berger. 9-point lead. Kentucky Premier trying to push the lead out to 10. There's Boley, top side, a three, good. Give me all three of them. My name is Miss Erin Boley, and I have 14 points in the contest. And now a 12-point Kentucky Premier lead, 43-31.
You're just seeing today why Boley's one of the top 10 players in the country in her class.
LaPratis with a tricky move down the lane, floated up off the window, no good. Allison Neese gets the rebound. Neese now will come into the forecourt. Their lead now is stretched on out there. Boley wanted it. Neese didn't see her. Now here's Robinson. Give it to Boley. Mayo trying to come in and be effective and aggravator. Robinson now going to get that screen from Boley if it comes. They peel it back out. They'll set it back up offensively. Long jumper in and out. McCune tried to get the rebound on the Robinson miss. It came back out to Robinson. Went out of bounds off of Kentucky Premier. So Gibson will come in. Dawson and Coglington will come back in as well. Gibson coming in for Kentucky Premier. What'd we just have? A warning on Parham, okay. So now we'll give it over to Coglington. Coglington will hold and work. Coglington going down the lane, she got fouled. And it will be on the floor. And the foul called on Allison Neese. Parham all the way down on the other end of the bench now. I guess he did not agree with that at all. Gabby LaPratis will be inbounding underneath the basket. Had to get it in. Coglington layup good. Time was running down. Deja Coglington now quietly with 9 points. It's back down to 10, but Kentucky Premier has kind of seized control. They trailed by 4 at the half. They're up by 10, and Robinson goes floating. No good. Rebound Gibson. Fought for it, and they're going to come away with it. Dawson gets it up ahead. Here's Coglington. Coglington all the way with the Euro step.
Oh, my.
Beautiful by Deja Coglington out of Huntington, West Virginia, class of 2016, 5'7". The lead now down to 8. We're at 6:48 to go.
West Virginia's waking up a little bit here offensively. Hopefully they can get him going defensively.
Down low, try to go with the high-low. Gibson tried to go high-low to Boley. Dawson's going to come away with it. Now it's time for a ProspectNation.com instant replay. And yes, ma'am. In the forecourt, we see you. Deja Coglington, Euro stepping to the hoop. Beautiful move. West Virginia all in the blue with the white trim. Kentucky Premier all in the gray with the green numbers and the black trim. 6:30 to go. Here's Gabby LaPratis. LaPratis is going to attack, kick it down in the corner to Mayo. Mayo back out to Eisenman. Eisenman to LaPratis. Good close out by Robinson. Didn't want to give up that shot. Coach Johnson now gets up. He wants to change the play calling assignments and do something different. Around the screen, LaPratis to Coglington. A three ball. Bang! She has warmed to the task right now. Deja Coglington.
That's 7 straight for her, isn't it?
Feeling good. 7 straight back points, and now it's a 5-point game. 43-38. Dump it down. There's Boley. Boley lost the footing. traveling violation. Lost their footing. A lot of players have lost their footing here. And now have we got a technical? Technical foul has been called on Coach Jared Parmley. So now who will go and get the free throw? It'll be Kristen Mayo. Coach Parmley has been upset and complained about this particular ref, and this particular ref has complained about him, and so she finally said, I'm gonna hit you with a tee. So Mayo hits the free throw. Hang on, Chris, you got your seatbelt on over there?
I just hope I get to stay on here. You know, I know Brandon will be sliding in here at the end of the broadcast.
5:56 to go. Mayo has dropped in two free throws in a row. That 10-point lead is gone. It's down to three.
I mean, you got, I was counting earlier, you know, over almost 180 schools here have been here. The whole back line is filled all the way from UConn. You know, every school in the country is here watching this matchup right now.
Yes, indeed. Coglington floating down the lane. No, got her own rebound. She's still in the lane, kicks it back to Mayo. Mayo going to drive, kick it into the corner. Down there's a floater by Dawson.
Good. Go.
They have came all the way fighting and flying back. Have the Thunder and Johnson pulling them on. It's down to one.
If you're Kentucky Premier, you want to get it into Boley or Shelby Gibson right now and hopefully get an easy bucket, maybe get to the free throw line.
Berger went driving. It wasn't there, and now Eisenman got it. It's a 9-0 West Virginia Thunder run. I don't know if we have it on the replay. Would Coglington pull for that three in the corner? Did you see the coach sitting there, what he did when she pulled that three? We don't have it. He put his arm up in the air, as in
the coach on the baseline.
Yeah, yeah, Gino did. That's what I'm talking about.
Hey, it's just the excitement. It's the excitement of Championship Saturday here.
It was the referee signal three. Yeah, because she was open and she'd been feeling it. 43-42. Uh-oh, off of the dribble, off somebody's foot. Robinson's gonna pick it up off the turnover. Robinson gonna drive. Shot is up, no good. Eisenman gets the rebound. Here comes Dunham back this way. A lead pass up for Dawson. Dawson taking the contact. No, she'll go to the free throw line. Shelby Gibson with the foul with 4:58 to go.
It's going to be interesting to see here over the next 5 minutes, West Virginia, you know, how much energy they expended to come back in this game here. And now if Kentucky Premier goes on a run, maybe a 5-0 run, are they going to be able to get it over the top here at the end of the game?
Dawson first free throw good. We are tied. Dawson second free throw good. That is an 11-0 run. They were down 43-33. Technically, they were down 43-31. So really, it's a 13-0 run now by West Virginia. Berger holding with 4:48, being pressured by Gabby Lapratis. Now Berger's going to try to attack, kick it over to Dunner. Duval stops. She couldn't pass it to you. He was out of bounds. Berger now brings it back. There's Robinson. Robinson peels it back out. Johnson is really letting his troops know how good defensively he is proud. Jeremy Parham had a technical in there, too. Yeah, there goes Boley. Stop. Jumper. Back iron. Did not get the roll. Rebound out of bounds. And it will go to West Virginia. At some point, you've got to stop the bleeding. It's a 13-0 run with 4:22 to go. West Virginia is on that run, and they'll be inbounding the ball, all in navy with the white numbers. Joel Hillsman, Chris Watkins, glad to be here with you. 4:20, less than that now. Dunham into the forecourt, right-hand dribble. Kicks it over to Wiseman. Wiseman, a long three. Bang! Courtney Eisenman, her second long three ball of the day. The run continues.
That's a heat check right there. That's just showing what they got.
That's with a bloody nose, too. Remember that, Chris. She got popped in the face and was bleeding earlier in the day and came back. Now Boley wanted to step back. Good closeout by Dawson. There's a three by Duval. Back iron. Rebound going to be chased down. It's on the floor. Dunham going to come away with it for West Virginia. She doesn't have numbers, but she wants to push the issue. No. She'll peel it back out or act it like it. Going to kick it in the corner. A three. No. Front iron. Boley gets the rebound for Kentucky Premier. 3:35 to go. 47-43, a 16-0 run by West Virginia, and now they just get the turnover. Dunham going to go all the way, layup front iron, no. Berger gets the rebound, rip and fight for it, and a foul with 3:23 to go. There's a foul on Jordan Dawson. So Frank will come in and Mayo will come back in. Let's take a look here at our ProspectNation.com instant replay as we have a timeout. Coach Johnson happy about him, but here it is. Eisenman again step out, and she knew what she was going to do. bang, on three of them. Now, that's the second one, and Gibson knows she can shoot that thing, may have to close out on her. That may add to the versatility and why Eisenman is still in, on the floor right now, bloody nose and all, as you take a look inside of the West Virginia huddle.
And, you know, in this type of matchup, she has to be on the game from a size standpoint there, both on the offensive and defensive end. You're Kentucky premier right now. What you want to do, you've got to get something good out of this timeout. You've got to get a good bucket, and then now you've sealed up that wound. You know, they've been bleeding for a while. You got to go ahead and close it up, and now look here to make this – just keep it consistent, you know. Don't roll over now just because West Virginia came back. And as good of a program they are and as good as they are, Coach, we know that's not going to happen.
3:23 to go. It's a 16-0 run currently for West Virginia Thunder. A lot of that has to go on the hands of Deja Coglington, 5'7 out of Huntington, West Virginia. She currently has 14 points in the contest. So 3:23 and a 16-0 run. It was 43-31 with 3:23 to go.
My time is coming to an end here.
Watkins will step away. We'll have a substitution. Clay is a little late getting here. I'm messing with him. They come when they want to come.
You're right. Better late than never, though never late is better.
That's right. It's a 16-0 run right now, Clay, by West Virginia. As you take a look at Coach's Row and that 16-0 run right there, yeah, that's Gino Auriemma. He has been into this contest. He's tried to put the phone away several times. They won't let it. McCune swooping across the lane, foul by Eisenman.
What a great move there from her to attack the middle of the paint, draw the foul. Now she goes to the free throw line.
So McCune will be going to the free throw line. She's hit three free throws here in this second half. And this is trying to break their long run. Good. They broke the run. It was a 16-0 run.
Well, it's amazing what Scott Johnson has done with this program. I think I got to start, you know, my time on the broadcast by saying that. And just the ability of this Gold team come out here and do their thing, put themselves in a position to win this game.
Well, this young lady here has had a lot to do with it, Ms. Deja Coglington. But good defensive effort there by McCune. We go under 3 minutes. Note Bowley and Gibson both on the floor. Robinson's shot is no good. Dawson gets the rebound and a foul, and we'll see who the foul is on. It'll be on Ansley Eubank out of Oakland, class of 2016, 5'8", and we'll come back this way now and shoot the one in.
Definitely glad that Eubank is okay.
Oh, yeah.
Had a little knee issue there the other day. Just sad, honestly, some, you know, knee problems in terms of some slippage and things like that, but they got her taped up. Our trainer, Yessie Combs, has her back to 100%, and she's good to go, ma'am, here for the last 3 minutes of the game.
When they came out and for warm-ups and I saw her, I thought that was a good relief.
Hey, great kid.
The fact that
man.
She actually stood up and was able to bend it and
no
work
question.
Around
no question.
Kind of told you a little bit.
First class kid and family.
Yes, sir. All right, 5-point game. 2:48, both free throws by Dawson were good. He's Brandon Clay. I'm Joel Hillsman. This is Peach State Basketball. Good. This is how we do it. This is the summer invite. McCune has got it. McCune good. Spinning on Eisenman. Shot, no. They tip and fight for the rebound. It comes out. Aaron Bowley gets it. Bowley to McCune. McCune makes her move. Eisenman, good D again, got fouled. I thought she had everything from the floor to the roof, though.
Well, you know what I thought was great there is when McCune went back into with the body. You saw Eisenman's wrist break there trying to make a play on the basketball, but absolutely love the way these two young ladies are going at it. Two uncommitted 16s really at it trying to make plays, whether it be McCune or Eisenman. Eisenman's earned herself some money, has a scholarship offer from the University of Georgia that just came in last week during the dead week. Scott Johnson's team still with multiple games left to play with us down in Augusta, so expect big things from her.
McCune free throw good. She's going to have to get better than putting her on the stripe. And they steal it. Eubank with a steal over to Bowley from a backside to Bowley. She passed it to her off her fanny, folks, with a layup. Good. It's 49-47.
Is this? Oh, what
game.
A pass.
Nice.
What
it
a
was,
pass from Mayo. I got a Mayo story here. Memorial Day weekend, about to catch a flight. Decide to stay. I'm like, all right, I'm going to push it. And when I tell you I watched Mayo have a heck of a weekend and finished it with a big-time game on a Monday, was hitting everything in sight against a very good Louisville team, Shively.
Eubank tried to come away with the steal, y'all. Tetra over there now.
Hey, the Louisville staff sitting three deep on this one. Help old Ansley Eubank up.
Yeah, three deep over there. It is three of them over there.
Well, and remember, head coach Jeff Walls is with the U19 team in Russia.
That's
so
right.
This is literally their entire staff in terms of their coaching staff here sitting on this game.
Collington went and slipped, and they was able to get a timeout. He was able to get the timeout. Jared Parmalee upset, has already been hit with one technical. He didn't like that fact because they got hit with the travel as well. Man, this gym is packed, man.
Well, you got to love it. I mean, this is the atmosphere you want as you see us focusing on the Kentucky Premier Parmalee. You see the replay there. Basketball delivered there by Mayo, and you talked about Coglinton and her ability to finish. That's the young lady that has offers on the table. You know, from schools such as Liberty, I talked with Coach Kerry Green. They'll be on hand in Augusta to watch her play. So a lot of positive things happening for the kids in this game. Mayo right now has a verbal on deck to East Tennessee State. Has really blown up, like I said, since her performance Memorial Day weekend. So plenty of players in this game, and that's why you got the atmosphere. I mean, literally standing room only. You can't see a single thing over there to get into the door. It's just packed up. I love it, man.
I could sit down, but then I couldn't see, so I have to stand up. Hey, that's okay. I'm
Scott,
loving
Scott,
it.
Scott Johnson's a big guy, man. He got them shoulders. Scott been in the weight room. I need to work out with Scott, man.
I know, that's right. All right, let's reset it for you now. 146.
I got something right here. They're actually running a new set. Scott Johnson trying to run a play. Hasn't run it. Actually just drew it out of the timeout.
Dawson working on Bowley. 140 to go, a four-point game. West Virginia leading 51-47. Dawson working on Robinson. No, that's Coglinton. Coglinton went behind the back. There goes Dawson. Dawson across the lane. It was deflected. McCune comes away with it. Up ahead now to Robinson. Robinson into the forecourt. Robinson now peels it back. Gives it over to Bowley. A three ball. In and out. No. Rebound. Eisenman. It's on the floor. They're fighting. They're scrapping. It's a jump ball. And whose ball will it be?
It's going to stay with Kentucky
it
for me here.
Kentucky, yeah.
Well, that's the shot, though. If you're Jared Parmalee, you want Aaron Bowley taking that shot. 29 last night in the semifinal did advance. You want her taking that look there at the three, the future Notre Dame Fighting Irish ball player.
Inbounding it underneath will be
Mikasa Robinson.
Mikasa Robinson.
Yeah, that's a good person to have inbound in the basketball. One of the best passers in the 18 class already.
She has 5 points in the contest.
Yo, this is like the playground outside, like Rucker. They're moving kids back. Kids are too close to the floor.
Nice. Bowley counted, scoring Aaron Bowley.
Yo, is this fun or what, man? Got our referee coordinator, John Wood, sitting to the
ball
left of me.
Ball tipped. And here's Kristen Mayo. She came away with a tip ball. There's Eisenman. Eisenman gives it to Dawson. Oh, 1 minute. 1 minute to go. 2 point game. West Virginia leading 51-49. Dunham going to go on the right wing. She peels it back out, being worked on by Eubank. 50 seconds. Eubank does not want to get blown by Dunnan. Aaliyah Dunnan really wants to go by her. She got a cookie on the ball a little bit, tip. Now she's leaning. Now there's a pass, an errant pass. Out of bounds, it will go to Kentucky Premier. Right here in front of us. How does that ball feel, Brandon?
It feels good,
got
man.
Got enough air in it?
Yeah, it's good. I'm about to hand it to Flipper Anderson, man. He knows how it feels, football or the basketball, man. Former professional football player for the LA Rams.
That's right. Willie Flipper Anderson. All right, here's Robinson. That's how many people in here. People come to ref to be here. Look at Bowley spinning in the lane. Oh. Dumped it off. A turnover. Coglinton going to come away with it. They're going to have to foul, though. 21 seconds. They give it in, and there's a foul right there, Duvall.
And if you're Scott Johnson, this is who you want going to the line right now. The way Mayo's played, the way she shoots the basketball, you're willing to live or die one way or the other with this young lady at the free throw line with a chance maybe to put this one away.
Kristen Mayo at the free throw line. Mayo with 10 points in the contest. 11 points.
Like I said, if you're Scott Johnson, you're willing to live or die with this kid at the line. She gets it. You know, I talked with her father before the game, and her grit, she just understands what it takes to be a winner.
Kristen Mayo, uh-oh. Lane violation.
Oh.
Lane violation on Eisenman.
That's
19
tough.
And 5, 10 seconds. It's a three-point game.
As if
Bowley
we needed any more suspense.
To Robinson, quickly into the forecourt. Robinson now going to attack quickly, going down the lane. A layup. No, got fouls. He'll get two. 13 seconds. Let's watch the clock now. Robinson going to the free throw line. This is a championship game, folks. Good. Just in case you didn't know the ramifications of this. Hashtag PSB Summer Invite. We're in Marietta, Georgia, the Suwanee Sports Academy. Cobb. Free throw, no. Tip, Eubank got the rebound underneath. Jump ball call. It'll go over to West Virginia. 10 seconds. Man, what a big offensive rebound.
Well, remember that change of possession there with the arrow in case there's another tie-up on a trap or something. That's a hustle play there by Eubank. Doesn't go in the book, but it does allow them to regain the possession. Good call here by Scott Johnson. Make sure he gets the inbound set he wants.
Yeah, he didn't like it. He was going to try to let him go, but then he didn't like the defensive set and say, well, you know what? I got a timeout. Let me take it. He takes that full timeout. 10.7 to go, 2-point game. Joel Hillsman, Brandon Clay, you're looking inside the West Virginia huddle right there. Scott Johnson and his staff, you're looking at Dunham and Mayo.
Try to get as much of that as you can. Just stand at half court. Yeah, get as much of that as you can.
I'm with you. You could have said that on there.
Hey, man, I got to make sure these people understand.
They don't. They
do not
understand.
The visual is worth a thousand words.
If
you're not here, you should be here right now. I mean, you look at these people, they're locked in. This is just unbelievable. There's so much going on, man, from a college coach perspective, a travel coach perspective. Obviously, Prospects Nation TV, powered by the SUV. I mean, there's just so much good stuff happening, man. It's overwhelming.
Air Force, LSU, Louisville, Rice, UConn, Tennessee. That's just the ones I can see. Texas Tech and everybody else is just here standing and having fun. 10.7 to go, 52-50. Now here comes Dawson. Dawson looks, a long lead pass, up ahead to Cognizant. Can she catch up with it? She does. Now Robinson has to foul her with 9.
What a play in the open floor. You see Colorado head coach Linda Lappy there, kind of looking like, oh man, please don't run through me. There's nothing between that wall and you except for me. Great play there. Gutsy call there by Scott Johnson and his coaching staff to know that the pass was going to get ahead of the floor for Dawson.
But you know what that reminds me of in the exhibition with the Indy Gym Rats with 5 seconds left. They ran the same type of play. Defensive effort was tipped the ball away. Now, Dana Evans still won the game, but it extended the game. Exact same similar play call.
Well, and you see them now making a change here. Gabby Lupart is checking in for Eisenman on the free throw, which is going to give them the ability to defend end-to-end. Good substitution here, it looks like, by West Virginia.
Coglington free throw, good. It hit the front of the rim and then curled on in. Deja Coglington has really shined in this second half, and she shined in front of a packed house of coaches.
What a
fantastic atmosphere, man.
It's
so hot in here now.
Man,
I see the coaches fanning themselves.
Hey, we're taking up all the good air, man.
That's the action, though. Free throw short, no good. Bowley gets the rebound. It's a 3-point game. 7 seconds. Bowley going
she
behind the back.
She lost the shot.
Bowley gets the timeout. 5.4.
There was a play yesterday at the end of the first half in the semifinal. Bowley grabbed the rebound with 7 seconds left, took the ball coast-to-coast, contact, and finished it. She wanted that possession. It'll be interesting to see if they're able to get her the basketball back here or if they run her as a decoy to get something for one of the secondary options. Now, at 5.4, CoachHimmy.com, down three, you probably have got to run this play designed for the three, not designed for the quick score and the foul, because you really are playing now at one possession. Anything under 10, in my opinion, you're playing one possession. You want to go ahead and take the shot that you need, not necessarily the shot that you would normally design it for in terms of trying to get an open layup. You got to find a way to get a three-pointer here.
5-4, 10 seconds. He's Brandon Clay, PeachStateBasketball.com. Any gym is home, ProspectNation.com. This webcast powered by SUV TV. Marcus Burnett, Lisa Burnett, they both right here with me. Do a fine job. They can't sit down either now. I don't see how Brandon's able to sit down. I guess because he's sitting here and dreaming this stuff up. Well, he just ready for it. Coach Johnson said he playing the percentages. He just tipped us off.
This is great.
He just tipped us off. They're going to foul. That's that old foul where you're down by three. Here they run the screen. They look at Bowley. Bowley pump fakes. A left wing three. Bowley, no good. Air ball. West Virginia rebounds, and that's the ball game. 53-50. West Virginia used a 16-0 run in this second half to come from behind and win.
Hey, let me tell you something, man. What a fantastic game. I mentioned that Bowley wanted the shot. They got her the shot. She took the shot. It didn't go in. It's interesting because West Virginia Thunder's Johnson team lost a semifinal game last night to the Annie Rago's Indy Lady Gym Rats on almost the same scenario with their go-to player in the backcourt, Taryn McCutcheon, taking a shot late, a three-pointer. It was a good look. It just didn't go in. So in back-to-back days, you're seeing kids ranked in the elite 50 in the country taking possible overtime shots, and they want those shots. And that's what I love, and that's what this atmosphere is created for. Arguably the game of the tournament, given the atmosphere and the surrounding, man, it doesn't get any better than that for the championship, Joel.
You are absolutely right. All right, we're going to reset everything. There's more PSB Summer Invite action coming up. Once again, the final score, 53-50. It is the West Virginia Thunder gold over the Kentucky Premier Squad.